Madovsky had left the cabinet open. On the shelf inside was a business card and a scribbled note. I picked up the business card. It read, Wilfred Hobbs, Fine Art Restoration. I made a note of the address. Then I put the card back where I'd found it. No point arousing Madovsky's suspicions. See a penny, pick it up. Then all day you'll have good luck. A Russian imperial egg. It looked rather plain. It was a thank you note from a British politician. Huh, Madovsky certainly had some dubious friends. Everything was in Cyrillic, except for a number, 1869. I suspected the medals weren't from the Moscow Debating Society. The note read, L-SERP drawings for you to check. WH.
Now we're cooking with gas.
I wondered if the painting could be in the portfolio that Madovsky had taken. It seems our Madovsky has friends in low places.
It's like my boss said, the guy wants to be a player.
Madovsky in Libya. Happy days. What kind of guy hangs a picture of himself and Colonel Gaddafi on the wall?
The kind who will commit murder in order to steal their own painting.
It was a Russian privatization voucher. I wondered why Madovsky displayed it so proudly. Russian novels. Madovsky was clearly a big Tolstoy fan. I should have guessed. Keyboard was Cyrillic. I didn't know the symbols. If I'd been able to remember the layout of a US keyboard, I might have been able to figure it out. Madovsky had an extensive collection of management books. The Seven Secrets of Leadership, 2009. The Business Bonaparte, 1983. Office Eagle or Management Mouse, 1998. Leather-bound classics, bought by the yard, no doubt. The catch had snapped. It was a beautifully inlaid cigarette box. The paperclip just flexed and slipped off the catch. By extraordinary good fortune, the coin I'd picked up was the perfect shape to flip open the broken catch. Fancy that. Keys are always useful. Romanovs. The same brand of cigarettes that were in the ashtray in Vera's security. Can you hear what they're saying?
Yes.
You should not have turned up here, Mr. Hobbs. I made it clear I would deliver the package later today.
I wanted to make sure it got to me all right. I've got a lot of work to do on it.
This is most inconvenient.
Madovsky's arguing with his visitor, Ops, about the portfolio.
That portfolio is important, I'm sure of it. It was locked. The study door's open now. Hear anything else interesting?
Hang on.
Listen, Hobbs, just take the portfolio and do your work. You are nervous, and I don't like that.
Understood. I have got a few questions, though.
I do not like questions, either. Hurry up.
I noticed a couple of people arriving. Who were they? They look like coppers.
They were from the insurance company.
Has the...
Hobbs is going to head off with the portfolio. Whatever's in there is important. We need to stay with it.
I got Hobbs' address from his card. When we're done here, we should check it out.
Okay, Josh, but hurry. Madovsky will be back soon.
I'm gonna check out the study.
Okay.
Wow, there must be millions of dollars worth of art on these walls. The drawer was open. My heart skipped a beat. But inside, I saw only a candy bar wrapper. The desk was magnificent. Those two little holes were just waiting for me to put my fingers in. I resisted the urge. Madovsky had left the cabin. I should have guessed. Keyboard was Cyrillic. A secret drawer popped open. I knew that publication date would be significant. At last, I was going to discover Madovsky's secrets. It certainly wasn't Madovsky's sock drawer. Hey, Nico! Come see this! I think we've struck gold!
Hang on! I'm coming!
Look! A letter from a guy called Gainan. His company, Wolfram, want to purchase La Maledizio. They're offering way over the asking price.
Anything connecting Madovsky to Vera?
Well, let's see. Here we go. A lease for Vera Security.
Aha! Then we have the proof we need.
Hang on, what's this? Expenses for a Mr. Shears. Waterloo Motors, one helmet. These are from Paris. Madame La Trex. Hotel Britannique, pizza. Nico, pizza. I think your friend Shears might just be Henri's killer.
Josh, what have we got ourselves into? I just heard the front door close. Madovsky's coming. Put everything back in order, quick.
Right. He'll never suspect we just ransacked his house for evidence.
Jules, the coin!
Damn, no time. Look cool, Nico. I'll handle this.
I apologize for the lengthy wait. As you can imagine, my time is at a premium.
That's fine, Mr. Madovsky. I think we're almost finished anyway.
And payment?
Very soon, monsieur. Very soon.
Is there anything else I can assist you with?
Nice collection of medals you have there, Mr. Madovsky.
I earned them serving my country.
Anywhere interesting?
Chechnya. Ever been there?
No, can't say I've had the pleasure. Is that a first edition of War and Peace?
Of course. Printed in 1869, a great year for my country's literature. And Tolstoy is the master.
Is that a picture of you with Colonel Gaddafi?
A deeply wonderful man. He was a great fan of the Impressionists.
Well, he certainly left quite an impression on Libya. So, what brought you into the art business, Mr. Madovsky?
Oh, an eye for great artists, an appreciation of fine culture, and a love of what you Americans call the greenback.
You must be upset at the theft of La Maledizio.
Yes, and disappointed that someone would kill for such a minor piece.
So this Hobbs guy, good friend of yours, is he?
No, we simply have a business arrangement. We've been through this already. Now please, if you're quite finished, I'm a busy man.
Thank you for your time, Monsieur Madovsky. We'll be in touch soon.
Well, no prizes for guessing where we go now.
Hobbs's place, right?
Got it in one. Madovsky's pretty shady, don't you think?
He bought our act, though. You make a pretty good insurance man, George.
Yeah, who'd have thought it?
By the time he realizes we're not assessing his claim, we'll have cracked the case and be toasting our success.
Here's hoping. Looks like rain.
Come on, let's get that cab. Taxi!
I think we just stepped off the London tourist trail.
I guess this Hobbs character doesn't like visitors.
Not the kind of place you'd expect to find a restorer of old masters.
Unless you didn't want to attract attention.
He's attracted ours. Let's see what Mr. Hobbs knows about La Maledizio.
And let's try and get a look inside that portfolio.
I wouldn't have been able to break the chain, or the padlock. The door was locked. Looking through the window, I could see that there was nothing in the van. Hobbs must have taken the portfolio inside. Slasha! I decided to leave the handbrake alone. Not a sound. The horn wasn't working. The large dumpster was full of garbage. Climbing drain pipes was something I preferred to avoid, unless I had a great reason to do so. It was Hobbs's mailbox. There was a note hanging out. For a second, I debated the morality of mail snooping. It was a short debate, and I won. I decided to open the letter. Dear Mr. Hobbs, due to previous incidents, we are writing to inform you that we will no longer be sending models to your address. It went on to discuss Hobbs's temper and other alleged infractions, some of which still carry the death sentence in certain less sophisticated cultures. Interesting. This could come in useful. They didn't go together. Never in a month of Sundays. They didn't go together. Not a snowball's... They didn't go... I don't think there's anyone home.
There's a light on upstairs.
There was definitely someone home. Climbing drainpipe, unless... That wouldn't work. Nico?
What's up?
The lights are on, but nobody's answering.
Maybe they can't hear you knocking. We could try some other way of attracting their attention.
That wouldn't have worked. The hood was definitely stuck. I popped open the van's hood. The engine was held together by rust and dirt. Everything was covered in a sticky film of dirty black oil. Half the wiring wasn't connected to anything. It was clear why the horn hadn't made a noise. Neither hornpipe was connected to either the battery or the cab. It was one of two horns in the van. It didn't seem to be connected to anything else under the hood. Two wires hung loose from it. I needed a better idea. A loose wire hung from the left-hand horn. If I had some spare cable, I could connect it to the wires from the cab. That was never going to happen. It was the van's engine. I didn't really have any reason to sabotage it. A bundle of short, severed wires was connected to the battery. None of the wires were connected to anything. That wouldn't work. A bundle of wires came into the engine bay from the dashboard. Many of the wires seemed to lead nowhere. A loose wire hung. If I had some spare cable, I could connect it to the... It was the van's engine. That was never gonna work. That wouldn't make... Piles of junk, mostly boxes of old paints and scraps of picture frames. Mixed in were wires, cardboard, and some dubious-looking old clothes. George Stobbart.
Ah, Monsieur Stobbart. I trust you have obeyed my instructions not to leave Paris.
Of course, Inspector.
Good. You clearly know which side your cookie is buttered. Now, I require your presence tomorrow at the murder scene for a reconstruction.
I see.
12 o'clock sharp, monsieur. Or, as you would say, high noon.
Sure.
Any failure to comply and I shall have you extraordinarily rendered. Have a nice day now.
And you. That was Nave. We're required back at the gallery tomorrow for a crime scene reconstruction.
Let me guess. Non-attendance is a criminal offense?
You got it.